Ready to go live on Facebook using Be Live, but you're not really sure what the process is? That's what I'm going to talk about in today's video blog. In today's video blog, I'm going to show you the process I go through in order to create my weekly live shows on Facebook using Be Live. I'm Ryan Perry. I help small business owners harness the power of video. I'm not going to talk a lot about Be Live specifically in this video. I simply want to step you through the process of how I go about not only creating the scheduled show every single week, but also the communication that I sent to the client that's really important. There's a couple of important links that you need to send out. And in order to do that, we need to jump on the computer. Let's go do it. Here we are on Be Live's website. This is where you're going to log in and start the process. Just so you know, Be Live works on computers. It does not work on smartphones. So if you just want to do a live broadcast with your smartphone, you will not need Be Live. The primary reason why I use Be Live is it makes it very simple for me to do interviews with somebody else who's not on site. I can just give them a link and they can remotely log in, and Be Live takes care of all the technical issues for me. In order to do this, you will need an account. You can do a free version where you essentially get two live shows a week, up to 20 minutes, and there are some limitations. Otherwise, go ahead and grab a light account. It's only $12 a month, or you can do a standard account that gives you some additional branding if you like. In order to get started, all you need to do is click on the red Get Started button once you're logged in. From here, you need to choose if you're gonna do a solo, interview, or talk show. I like to do the interview where I'm actually talking with somebody remotely. Now you need to kind of just fill out some basic information. Are you going to do this on your own personal timeline, or do you want to do it on your group page, an event, or in a business page that you manage? For me, I always do a page, and then all you have to do is select one of your pages. I'm going to scroll down and grab Simple Biz Support. This box is going to be your description box. When this uploads to Facebook, this is the description that's going to show up just above the video. So go ahead and make sure you let people know who's your guest, why should they watch, give them a reason to be interested. Now, here's a really key one. This is one I messed up on a couple of times. If you go straight to Create Broadcast, you're going to go live immediately. What I like to do is I like to schedule my shows out for a couple of different reasons. One, I do a weekly show at the same time so that the audience members know, okay, just like a TV show, I know to be on Ryan's channel at 10:20 every single Tuesday. In order to do that, you need to create a Facebook live broadcast. You must click this button, otherwise you're going to miss out. I wish they would just leave this up and you had the option to click it, because I didn't notice it a couple of times and forgot. There are some limitations. I think you have to plan out maybe 20 minutes ahead of time, and you cannot go more than a week into the future. So today's May 31st. Let's say my next show I want to do on June 3rd, as an example. We're just going to click the buttons. What time do you want to do the show? For me, I do them at 10:20 all the time, and you're ready to rock and roll. You can go ahead and also upload an image if you'd like. Add your email. The other key one that you need to remember each time is to incorporate your branding if you have that functionality with the plan that you chose. What's nice is you can add a couple of different brands. So if you're managing a couple of different channels or shows, you can go ahead and add these templates, and also make sure you add your branded color. That way it will show when your broadcast goes live. If you miss this step, it's not something you can go back and edit, so you want to make sure that you do it up front. Once you save all of this information, all you need to do is click the Create Broadcast. Now, for me, since I am not going to create a new show right now, I'm just going to do testing only. Essentially, it's the same information. When you click the Create Broadcast, this is the next screen that you're going to get. And this is something you can do, by the way, if you want to just do a test, is you could do a test with somebody up front. It doesn't go live anywhere, and I don't want my people to be notified that I'm just doing a test. So that's why I didn't post it to the homepage. So here's some additional information. Once you click finish, here's the key link right over here. Go ahead and copy that link. This is what you're going to share with your guest in order to go live. On your end, you just have to click the connect camera, which I'm not able to do right now because I'm recording the screen share. Once you have this information, the next thing, there's two things that I do. One of the things, the next things that I do is I will go to my Facebook page, and now the show has been posted. Here's the show information. The one problem is, so as an example, next week my guest is going to be Beth Barney. This does not automatically link. You have to go in and edit it, which I've already done. So by clicking the three little buttons up here, make sure you do edit post. And then you can go ahead and do your, you know, you do the at sign. And then if I wanted to add, if I can spell my name correctly, Ryan Perry, I could go ahead and do that. So I always like to incorporate my guest name into the show. That is something you will have to add afterwards. It's not going to be built into the transition when you save it in Be Live. So go in the Facebook, add your guest name. That way they get notified through Facebook. That way they know where to share it and where to connect. The other thing you want to do is you want to add a title and add some tags that are relevant to your show. Once you're done, go ahead and save this. One thing you do want to be careful of is you never want to edit the schedule through Facebook. Otherwise, it's going to throw Be Live and Facebook out of sync, and that's not going to be good. Once you're done here, go ahead and close this down. I'm not going to save anything right now. The next thing you'll want to do is you want to let your guests know that the show is set and where do they go and what do they do and all that type of fun stuff. So there's a couple of things that you're going to need to do. One is I just have an email template. I have my title that I put in the email, and then I just have a template here that goes through a couple of things. One, I give them a link to the show. Remember, that came directly from Be Live right here. This URL, I would go ahead and paste that here that says, hey, this is the link to the show. You have to use this link at this time in order to be a guest. There are some technical things with Be Live that your audience should be a note that your guest, excuse me, should know about, such as making sure they have good internet. Do they have a webcam with audio? Be Live only works with Chrome, so I let them know to make sure they have a Chrome browser and they do need a Facebook account. Additionally, I give them some different tips and tricks to make sure that they're presentable. They have the correct type of lighting going on. There's not clutter in the background and those type of things. The other thing that I do is I want them to promote and share the show also. This link up here that we get from Be Live is only goes to the guest. It doesn't go public. In order to share the show, what you'll need to do is click these three little dots here, click on the down arrow, see more options, and then click on embed. From the embed page, you have to click advanced options, and this is going to give you the actual URL of the video. This is what anybody who wants to watch, all the viewers, need to know. This is the URL I push out on Twitter and my other social media through email. All the different ways that you want to promote the show, this is the email that will link directly to the show. So when I send that email out to the client, not only do I give them this link to join the show, but I also go, hey, tell your audience about the show. Here's the link. Go ahead and pop that link in there. Now you're done. You've created the show. Your client has the link. You've gone into Facebook and you've edited the show to make sure that it is your guest is linked and notified. And you've given your guest an email with some technical information, how to get to the show, how to promote the show. All you need to do now is actually go back to Be Live on the day of the show. And over here where it says this broadcast in red text, over here it's actually going to have a countdown timer that will let you know when the show is going to go live. And then there is a button right here. I don't know if you can see it. It says start broadcast. That will become available to you.
The next thing you want to do after you broadcast, I always embed the show into my blog. I actually have a separate section from my blog called podcasts, and that's where I put all my live shows and I embed the video into the show. The way you're going to need to do that is once the show goes live and it's complete, let me scroll down. It's still here on Facebook. So here's last week's show. All I need to do is click the three little arrows and click the embed button. And this link right here is the embed code that you can go ahead and share it onto your WordPress site or your blog, however you want to embed it. At this point, I'm all done and I start over for the next week.
That's how easy it is to schedule a live Facebook show using BeLive. I'd love to know what you think. Be sure to leave a comment below. Let me know if there's any other tips or tricks that maybe you would like to see or that I missed regarding live Facebook shows using BeLive. If you found the video helpful, feel free to hit the like button and subscribe. All right, everybody, until next time, take care.